Thanks for joining us for another virtual version of the Advertising Club of Richmond's 2020 Richmond Show. Here to welcome you is Club President Vera Magdiva.
Good evening, and thank you so much for tuning into tonight's virtual show. We are so appreciative of your continued support. Dystopia had seemed like a very appropriate theme for 2020. Worldwide, it was a year that no one expected and one that proved to be heartbreaking and difficult. One silver lining to the year was how the advertising community showed up for other communities. Advertising helped promote staying healthy, supporting frontline workers, fighting injustice, and supporting small businesses, and so much more. We're here to celebrate you and your incredible work as a silver lining today. From the entire Advertising Club of Richmond board, congratulations to every single one of you. It's well deserved. While my year as president is coming to an end and we haven't been able to connect in person, I hope you'll join us for an in-person celebration 1 week from today, June 10th, at New York Deli in Carytown at 5:30. I look forward to seeing faces, new and familiar, and having one last hurrah. But now, let's kick off the show.
Now introducing our three judges for the 2020 Richmond Show. Allison Sarasso, Ron Huey, and Lanil Rodrigue. And the 2020 Richmond Show wouldn't be possible without our incredible board members, or our fantastic show sponsors, Spang, Simplify, Alice Blue, and Worth Higgins. Voiced and hosted by yours truly, Paul Schmidt. Starting with our young and hopeful, the future of advertising, the Student Show. The bronze winners are Amber Wilson, Old Dominion University, Tenement Museum. Amber Wilson, Old Dominion University, East Coast Bicycles. Heather Anderson, Virginia Commonwealth University, Galaxy Diner Radio Spot.
This world is being watched by a higher intelligence. We may not know their true identity, but one thing is confirmed. They have landed here for something. Sources confirm that Richmond has seen some unusual disturbances these past hours. Origin of intent is unclear. However, Galaxy Diner has established that these invasive intruders have begun to eat man's burgers, enjoying these delicious commodities as if they were one of us. And you, too, can get the best burger in the galaxy. Only at Galaxy Diner.
David Ligon, VCU Brand Center, Harry Tay from 23andMe. Kyle Talley, Virginia Commonwealth University, the Budweiser Bottle Bank.
Growing up is hard. Getting older might mean more freedom, but it also means more responsibility and a lot more uncertainty. And as one of America's oldest breweries, Budweiser's done plenty of growing up. After all, we've lived through a depression, a recession, two world wars, and now an epidemic. So when we say we know what you're going through, trust us, we do. That's why we want to help American adults with one of the most common issues they face today, saving for the future. Introducing the Bottle Bank, a way to save and invest while enjoying all your favorite Budweiser beverages. Here's how it works. Sign up, and anytime you purchase Budweiser products, the Bottle Bank takes 5% of the cost and drops it in your bottle. After that, you use the money how you like. Save, invest in stocks or crypto, or just spend it on one more round for the crew. The choice is yours. So drink up, America, and do so knowing that you've just become a little bit wiser when it comes to your finances.
Nolan Shear, Virginia Commonwealth University, Justin's Essential Fuel. Winning silver, we have Kofi Roberts, Virginia Commonwealth University, hashtag meet my bud.
Budweiser, the king of beers, question mark? When it comes to the younger demographic, Budweiser is losing its crown. In fact, Bud has seen a $342 million decrease in sales overall. How can Bud climb back to the top? By being bold and giving back to the service industry, a sector that is 90% 21 to 34-year-olds. Introducing hashtag MeetMyBud, a campaign focused on highlighting service industry workers who are making their community a better place. To begin, Budweiser will scour social media using hashtag MeetMyBud to find these unsung heroes. We'll create custom cans with their faces, ask what they'd like to share, and ship their stories nationwide to show our appreciation for the hard work they do. The cans will be sent out with bartends that have a QR code to take you directly to the hashtag MeetMyBud website. There you can nominate a service industry hero in your city, apply to our COVID relief fund, and learn more about our featured service industry workers. Budweiser is ready to do more than just show their support.
Budweiser, meet my bud.
Jenna Wersch, Virginia Commonwealth University, Pop-Up Play.
The way we listen and see music has changed since the coronavirus pandemic, but our love for music hasn't. We're streaming more music than ever today. And we're not commuting to work or school as much, but we're still listening to our favorite music, news, and podcasts just in different places. So what does this mean for Spotify's Daily Drive? How do we get people to listen to the Daily Drive when most people turn into this media in their cars? Our solution is to make the Daily Drive more interactive. So we're introducing a new way to interact, listen, and learn with the Daily Drive pop-up play feature. Whether you're listening to the Daily Drive in a car, your home, or anywhere else, pop-up play connects you to your music, news, and podcasts in a new, exciting, and interactive way. Our augmented reality experience gives you the ability to learn more about what you already love and discover something new. Want to know more about a song, podcast, news story? Just activate pop-up play. Explore more, learn more, play more with pop-up play.
Kofi Roberts, Virginia Commonwealth University, The Daily Ride.
By offering extremely tailored experiences, Spotify has been able to differentiate themselves from the pack of music streaming services. However, One of Spotify's best offerings, The Daily Drive, has been put in the rearview due to the pandemic. The commute to work for many is now the distance between the bedroom and the desk. While long travel times has been eliminated for many, a need to be outside has only grown. Once taken for granted, fresh air is now a precious commodity and outdoor activities are spiking like never before. So how can Spotify take advantage of this newfound love? By turning the Daily Drive into the Daily Ride. We'll start by announcing Daily Ride stations on social media, geotagging locations within major cities across the U.S. to get the word out. When riders are ready to bike, they'll sync up to the ride with their Spotify Premium account, where a song will be selected from the playlist matching the rider's PPM, or pedals per minute. Outfitted with speakers so your ears can still be on alert while riding, a sick paint job, and LED lights that will display the album art of a rider's current song, these bikes will certainly stand out. After riding, users can post their experiences across social media, ensuring there will be plenty of FOMO. And in case one of these bikes is stolen, we'll display the holder's Daily Drive playlist. Daily Ride, the new Daily Drive.
The gold winners are
Jess Leonard, VCU Brand Center, Dubweiser.
Bailey Browning, Virginia Commonwealth University, Postcards on Spotify.
From commuting to communicating, the last year has been, well, for lack of better words, different. Simply put, we aren't seeing our friends the way that we used to, and we definitely aren't leaving home the way that we used to. Isolation has never felt so isolating. But Spotify believes that distance does not have to mean disconnecting, which is why they have created a new feature that allows users to connect through music. Introducing Postcards by Spotify. How it works is users will pick from several pre-made playlists or create their own, then add a voice message to send to their friends individually as postcards, or post the cards to their socials for an even bigger connection. When sent to another user, the voice message and the songs from the postcard will be automatically added to that user's daily drive. Our hope is that by sending a little bit of love, encouragement, or gratitude someone's way, we can all help to make each other's new normal a little less different. Spotify as a brand would also be able to get in on this exchange of positivity by placing their own postcards to the world on outdoor ads across the globe. And when the pandemic passes and the world starts to look a little more normal, we will still have these postcards to look back on.
And now, for the best in show.
David Ligon, VCU Brand Center, Alcatraz Island. It will change you.
Now for our scholarships. The Excellence in Creative Education Scholarship is awarded to a first-year student at the VCU Brand Center, and this year's winner is Corey Hambly. And winning the Women in Advertising Scholarship, awarded to a rising senior within the VCU Robertson School of Media and Culture, is Emily Dong. Congratulations. We'd like to thank Simplify for their sponsorship. Simplify is the leader in programmatic advertising built for the precision and scale of addressable, mobile, and OTT CTV advertising.
Simplify presents addressable CTV, combining the power of TV with the targeting and attribution of digital. Simplify's addressable CTV delivers massive reach with the ability to scale without sacrificing precision. TV buyers can generate incremental reach with household-level targeting, frequency controls, reporting, and insights. To learn more about Simplify's addressable CTV and what it can do for your clients, visit simply.fi.
When things seemed chaotic, they made sure to get things done. The Production Show. Here's who's taking home the bronze. Overcoast, UPS, Be Unstoppable.
It's time to let go. Lean into your fear. Embrace the unknown. It's time to revive, thrive, time to rise, no matter the odds. You can get knocked off your path and blaze a new trail forward. Let's reimagine, reinvent, boot up, and get ready to rise again.
Every day is another chance to make it happen. That's why I don't wait until Monday.
I get more done during my coffee run than some people do all day.
Spang TV, Ann Overa Unapologetic.
Let's talk about the V word, not vagina. Literally, the V word. When we talk like that about reproductive health, we're apologizing. So consider this an unapology. From Ann Overa. It's a new annual birth control ring. It goes in your vagina. Vagina. It lasts for a whole year. You put it in, and then once a month, you pull it out. You go to the pharmacy once. There are zero procedures, because zero is the number of procedures we prefer. What we've put up with just to not get pregnant is not normal. But now there's annual, comfortable, controllable birth control.
Overcoast, TIAA, I shall not live in vain.
Every day, they have to be ready for anything. Let's make sure they're ready for tomorrow, too. TIAA's Century of Retirement Expertise can help you give them monthly income for life. Those who help others prepare for the future should never feel unprepared for their own. Give them the confidence of monthly retirement income that never runs out. If I can stop one heart from breaking, I shall not live in vain. If I can ease one life the aching, or cool one pain, or help one fainting robin unto his nest again, I shall not live in vain. A lifetime of dedication deserves retirement income that lasts a lifetime. TIAA, never run out.
Ryan Hunter Production, Mimetic.
Slowing down, old man. No.
Overcoast, Ford, Raised by Goats.
The ultimate adventure tool, with all the storage to hold even more adventure tools. The all-new adventure-ready Bronco Sport. There are two parts of the wild. The journey and the destination. So we built the Bronco Sport with both in mind.
Overcoast, DoorDash, dashing by the numbers.
In the month of April, Dashers collectively earned over $515 million. They delivered to communities across the country. They delivered to those in need and to those we need most. They delivered happiness, flapjack stack nightcaps, and of course, the essentials. Want to support your community and your checking account? Deliver with DoorDash today.
Winning silver, we have. The Martin Agency, crack open happy.
What if cracking an egg could start your day in a happier place? You know, it's like your happy place, only happier. A place where the soundtrack can be switched with a snap. Where tortillas hold you tight, and scrambling means you're doing mornings right. Where nobody says meh, and if they did, only ironically. Oh, and by the way, this is an ad for eggs! So this is a place where you can do wheelies on unicycles. A place where getting egged is a good thing. Where humdrum hits different. And DMV stands for Don't Miss Vacation. Where stepping on a crack actually fixes grandma's back. Where bread is toasted but never burnt. Where sunny side up means you always land on your feet. Where Humpty Dumpty actually had a great fall. A nice one. Where you can have your pancake and eat it too. Where traffic always autocorrects to terrific. And where binge watching never ends, never ends. Start your day in a happier place. Crack open happy. Happy egg.
Stolen moment. Who am I?
I'm an earthquake, tornado, a young nigga from Richmond, VA that shakes and flips things back together. I'm a natural miracle that washes away disasters and my voice be a hurricane. A two-legged creature that runs seas with the tip of a pen. I'm an architect, blueprint details of details. My structure is solidified from the laws of my childhood. I'm blessed that my scars didn't come from straight bullets. I'm blessed that my scars came from playing tag on the concrete. I'm a boy who pretends to be a man. A boy that loves the sight of.
Overcoast, Google TV, launch anthem.
Gold winners are
the Martin Agency, Oreo, the Fair.
Me and you, together we can lose.
Overcoast, ESPN, there's no place like home.
Can they play in front of empty gyms?
How are they going to keep players engaged?
We just sit here and hope that they can make it work.
Here we go!
We didn't know if we were going to get here, but we're here.
Tonight, we begin this 2020 season playing in front of a bunch of cardboard cutouts.
How gratifying is tonight?
It's amazing to be back.
Is this as weird for you guys as it is for us?
That's the guy.
3.7 seconds remaining.
Come on!
Dodgers pulls up, three-pointer!
To MLB opening day here.
And taking Best in Show for production this year.
The Martin Agency, Boneless Thugs in Harmony.
For 25 years, Bone Thugs in Harmony have continually reinvented rap. But today, a name change threatens to tear the group apart.
It's not an argument. We boneless, not checked this out. Ain't no doubt about that.
A new love for boneless wings led to a new name.
We need to be boneless thugs now. Bottom line. I'm not gonna lie, but I like boneless wings, man. Whatever, it is what it is. Boneless wings, what?
But not everyone was on board.
I ain't changing s***.
Bone Thugs in Harmony changes their name to Boneless. It's preposterous.
With the groups, it's always majority rules.
Always.
So right now, it's 3-1.
I said I'm not changing.
You're changing the name.
Sometimes lazy change bone. Is good. Growth is good, Lay.
When Lazy Bone has his opinion, we all have ours.
I ain't doing shit.
Just try to bone his wings, Lazy.
The group extended a sauce-covered olive branch towards Lazy.
I mean, they actually pretty good, but they don't have no bones.
They boneless, baby.
They ain't changed your name good.
Damn.
Despite Lazy's misgivings, the name change took off.
Dipped, boneless wing. Dipped.
Dipped.
In gold.
In gold.
Boneless still rhymes with bone. Boneless is cloneless. Trying to keep up with the bones as Jones is boneless. A few letters we change in it. It's not going to change the heart of where we come from or what we about or what we talk about. It's going to still be bone. Just list.
We boneless only, we boneless only, we boneless only, we boneless only, we boneless only.
Will the name change stick? Will the new Buffalo Wild Wings boneless wings be the end of the Bone Thugs? Only time will tell.
I ain't changing s***.
We boneless only, we boneless only, we boneless only.
We'd like to give a special thank you to Alice Blue for providing the intros for this year's show. Alice Blue is a Richmond-based integrated production studio composed of highly imaginative visual storytellers. Through creative exploration, craft, and collaboration, we bring your story to life.
Like
Thanks for watching and hope you're enjoying the winter so far. Congratulations to everyone. Ahead of the show, we teased that there was something new on the horizon. For nearly 30 years, the Richmond Show has honored advertising greats with the infamous Cannonball. It's displayed proudly on shelves and desks across Richmond and beyond. It's a truly unique award. The Cannonball has been an important part of the Ad Club's history that was introduced as an award as it was tied to the show's then location, Tredegar Ironworks. It quickly became beloved by show winners. As the advertising industry evolves, and so does the Ad Club, it's important for the Richmond Show, and by extension, its coveted award, to also evolve. What will always remain constant is our mission to foster a socially responsible creative community, and we have to practice what we preach. We must always do good. This will be the last year of the Cannonball at the Richmond Show. The symbol that's so deeply rooted in Confederate history will be giving away to something that represents our mission more closely. What that looks like will be up to our community. As my presidency wraps up, the next group of Ad Club leaders will be ushering the club into a brighter future. Your next Ad Club president, Arden Granger, who has been my right hand for the past year. She has been assembling her team of board members, and they will be sharing what the future holds for the Richmond Show Award. While change is hard, please don't fear. The club still plans to give you something to be excited about and display proudly in your offices. And now, here's Arden.
It is an honor and a privilege to be the newest president of the Richmond Ad Club, and I'm so grateful for the relationships I've formed throughout my time in this great organization. As Vera mentioned, we're closing one chapter of our history as we move away from the Cannonball, but we are very energized as we evolve and enter a new year. Our community is at the core of who we are, so please be on the lookout in the coming months for how you too can play a part in our exciting evolution. This upcoming year will allow us to reconnect in ways through which we haven't been able to in over a year, and we are really looking forward to offering more programming, both educational and social, to our members. I can't wait to see everyone at our 2020 Richmond Show celebration next Thursday at 5:30 p.m. at New York Deli. Enjoy the rest of the show.
In 2020, there may not have been a lot to do, but these works got audiences to engage. It's the interactive show. The Bronze Winners. Yabo, Dash In, Digital Display. Geico, savings are calling.
Hey, so I gotta tell you something very important. Ooh, no wait, I have to do something first.
Wee!
Okay, so I was at the store and this raccoon approaches me and... And then Tim, you know Tim, he starts telling me about... saving money with Geico.
My gosh.
You won't believe this. So Connie just told me that Linda told her that Larry said that Amanda said that Rhonda saved a bunch of money by switching to Geico. Isn't that crazy? Yeah, not a lot of hot goss today.
Helium Studio, Holiday Barn Pet Resort.
Helium Studio, Alliance.
Evergive, Richmond Ballet, the State Ballet of Virginia. Collab. LCLD, leaders at the front. Stolen Moment, Who Am I?
Who am I? I'm an earthquake, tornado, a young nigga from Richmond, VA that shakes and flip things back together. I'm a natural miracle that washes away disasters, and my voice be a hurricane. A two-legged creature that runs seas with the tip of a pen. I'm an architect. Blueprint details of details. My structure is solidified from the laws of my childhood. I'm blessed that my scars didn't come from straight bullets. I'm blessed that my scars came from playing tag on the concrete. I'm a boy who pretends to be a man.
Convoy, Convoy website. Department of Justice, Stories Over Stigma.
gold we have.
Gable, dash in, snackagram, microcycle.
Closing indoor operations statewide for restaurants.
Bars, restaurants, coffee shops all closed.
Could we be looking at more closures or, you know, a mandate that all bars and restaurants close nationwide?
I think you're seeing the best of everyone step up and make sure that everyone's taken care of.
The restaurant industry is making a plea to its customers to help them get through this.
Delivery is a great way to still get your favorite meals safely and quickly.
We are open for delivery.
So we're going to be working with DoorDash to donate meals.
And comment below on how you're helping out in your local community.
Restaurants are adapting to this new normal.
Delivery is now exploding.
All that business that we would have in-house is just pretty much transferred all over to delivery.
Delivery orders have become their lifeline.
We are seeing that some of them are not just surviving, but they're actually thriving.
Now, the best in show for interactive.
Yabo, Department of Justice, Stories Over Stigma.
We'd like to take a moment to thank Spang TV for their sponsorship of The Richmond Show. Spang is a full-service creative production studio based in Richmond, Virginia, shooting around the world. Home to a diverse and dynamic family of filmmakers, editors, colorists, and producers, we approach each project with the goal of making something unforgettable. Whether we're crafting branded content, commercials, web and social assets, or documentary film, our process is inclusive, collaborative, and fun.
People often ask how we got the name Spang. Well, it was a Saturday morning, my two sons played on the floor, and the laundry churned in the next room while I sat at my kitchen table, scratching out a business plan for my new production company. I was meeting with my first potential client in 2 days, and while I had a business plan, I didn't have a business name. I said out loud, what am I gonna call this thing? And right at that moment, the clothes dryer went off with an alarm. When it did, my 2-year-old son Spencer popped out from under the kitchen table, threw his arms in the air, and proclaimed, Spang! And there it was, the perfect solution found in an unexpected place. Spang was born.
Advertising work that really brightened up 2020. The Design Show. Winning bronze, we have
Convoy, Brantley Park Wine Labels.
Why do all egg brands look boring? That's a great question. It's because they all act like eggs. What if there was an egg brand that acted more like a happiness brand? Oh, and by the way, this is an ad for eggs. We had one goal: transform ordinary into extraordinary. Happiness starts with happy color, inspired by Mother Nature herself. Like a true happiness company, the brand needed to be, well, happier. There we go. Happiness has character. Ever see a Yeti ride an egg? Well, now you have. Even the smallest things can be happy. Love that one. I know, you're thinking a poolside massage with toast is lovely. But What about boring banner ads? Can they live in this wonderful world? It's quite simple, you see. One can make anything happy when you're a happiness brand. Because eggs don't have to be boring when they're happy. Happy Egg.
Campfire and Company, Jamaica House. The silver winners are Alice Blue, Veterans Coalition for Vaccination, Call to Arms.
Glammed up their classic cookie. Lady Gaga Oreo.
Oh my God.
One, two, three, Gaga. Okay, yeah.
Thinking of you, greeting cards during a pandemic. Winning gold, we have the Martin Agency. Buffalo Wild Wings, Moist Thai Lettuce.
Let's face it, no one really gives a crap about Father's Day.
Father's Day is the worst holiday in the world.
Not even dads do. All dads want to do to celebrate Father's Day is eat wings and watch sports. And what is Father's Day famous for? Lame-ass gifts like the necktie.
Happy Father's Day, dear father. Happy Father's Day to me.
But that's where Buffalo Wild Wings saw an opening. What if we took the shittiest Father's Day gift of all, the tie, and combine it with the preferred Father's Day activity, eating wings, to make one Voltron of an idea called the Moist Tilet, a necktie made of moist towelette material. I shit you not.
It literally is a moist towel in the shape of a tie.
It's an actual towelette.
That's cool.
It's a ridiculous idea, so we made a very serious video about the making.
Made from the finest, most absorbent materials.
And we also delivered the thing in a giant packet, just like a real moist towelette, which is cool.
Smells like one of those mini handy wipes in the shape of a tie.
Speaking of cool, check out this chicken bone tie clip we made to accessorize. People were confused and delighted. Once we went live, it sold out in under 3 hours and took social media by storm, getting over 11 million total impressions. Our story was also picked up by media juggernauts like Trend Hunter, Mashed, and even Bro Bible. And at the end of the day, we were able to not only elevate B-dubs, but we also made Father's Day a little less sucky.
Dad's on time!
Created Wandering Waiters Premium Shucked Oysters. Taking the best in show in the design category. The Martin Agency, Buffalo Wild Wings Rally Cap.
To spark a come-from-behind victory. A sports superstition for those who believe there's always a chance for a comeback. And after the worst year ever, that's exactly what America needed.
We want a rally! Yeah!
So America's sports bar answered. Introducing the Buffalo Wild Wings 2021 Rally Cap. A hat designed from the inside out to be worn inside out. With one goal in mind, staging a comeback in 2021. Flipping that flaming dumpster, climbing on top and yelling, "This is our year!" When we dropped our hats in the final days of 2020, it was clear we weren't alone. America was hungry for a comeback. Some even got a little carried away. Leading the charge was sports' most down-and-out athletes. After Trey Mancini's battle with cancer, he was ready. After Elena Deladon was forced to sit out all of 2020, she was ready. And after Lou Williams
just set fire to what's left of the Clippers' season, they hit him with 10 games of quarantine,
he was definitely ready. Millions who suffered setbacks in 2020 joined to grab 2021 by the horns and haul tied into submission. This year, we're all on the same team, and we've all got the same dream, to make 2021 the greatest comeback ever.
Now, it's time to recognize the Advertising Person of the Year.
Jessica Collins.
Well,
When I was told I was named Ad Person of the Year, I was completely in shock. Thought it was a complete joke. You know, I have a lot of goals as a professor that I think about, and I just want to inspire confidence. You know, like I think a lot of students come to me and think that they should be at the top of their skill level, they should be the best art director, the best copywriter, or the best planner. And it's not about that. It's about being able to be yourself, walk in a room, be confident, talk about your idea in a way that's different from someone else. And if I can see the progression of a student from the beginning of the semester to the end, and see that even if that confidence dial has moved a tiny bit, I've done my job. And that's what makes me really happy at the end of the day. I can remember distinctly, you know, March 2020 hits, the world is crazy. We all went virtual. We had no idea what was gonna happen. And two alums came to me, Courtney Foster and Kevin Nguyen, and said, we have got to do something. Like, we're sitting at home behind our computers. What can we do to help people that have lost their internship opportunities? And we created Camp Adventure. We literally thought 6 people would show up. We thought we would provide camp and maybe 6 students would come. We received over 300 applications. And in with the span of 2 weeks, we pulled off this 8-week program. And it ended up being way bigger and way more impactful than we ever thought. To have been able to create this network was something I never imagined. I think the sky's the limit for Richmond. And being somebody that's a native Richmonder, nothing makes me more excited than to say that. Big agencies, small agencies, middle-sized agencies, freelancers, entrepreneurs. The only challenge is just getting more people to come here and to see that it's doing such great things. I think that's gonna come. I think the work is gonna continue to be put out there, and then people are gonna see that and they're gonna wanna come here. But I don't see any huge challenge. I think Richmond speaks for itself, and it's a great, great town.
Jessica, it's an honor to recognize you. Thank you for everything you do to make an impact in the Richmond community. And last but not least, taking home bronze, we have Alice Blue, Veterans Coalition for Vaccination, Call to Arms. Yabo, rev your bev box. Collector Studios, come together, Virginia.
I think it's really, really important for everyone in your local communities to buy local. Not just support local, but buy local. Bills don't stop. They're there, and they need money coming in so that they can pay them and they can stay in business, and we can have this amazing culture on the other side of this. Normally are making whiskey every day, working on distributing it and selling it, having the best time working at the best place on earth.
Yabo, stop the shit show.
How you doing, man?
How are you?
I'm well.
You use some high-minded language. I'm just going to say it like it is. That was a shit show.
Tonight was a shit show.
Shit show.
That's what it was.
Mac McCarthy, when we say, if that wasn't a mess, it'll do till the mess gets here.
Okay, hang on.
Siddall Communications, Mad Virginia TV campaign. Yabo, Virginia Department of Justice, Stories Over Stigma. The silver winners are Siddall Communications, Mad Virginia TV Scrapbook.
The Martin Agency, DoorDash Southside Magnolia.
To be black in America is to be an entrepreneur. You're the CEO of the business, and the business is staying alive.
Black-owned businesses in our community have had an undue stigma because people didn't trust our goods and services.
Eternal God, we want to send a special prayer throughout the city of Chicago with your hand upon the Inglewood community.
Chicago's like that crossroads of everything. It's a certain beat. It's a vibe.
You gotta schedule vacations in your five-year plan. You gotta schedule celebrations in your five-year plan. You gonna have several revelations in your first 5 days. In your first 5 minutes, have your first five fans. For like 45 minutes, take
our story begins in the South Side. My grandfather used to say, you create your own luck. You create your own opportunity. I never saw him work for anybody. And that blew my mind. I learned business from them.
The way of the art. I know that I had a good start. I
met him and he was talking about all these businesses that he was gonna have. And I've watched him get a bunch of no's. I've watched him get laughed at, but he just wouldn't stop. At a certain point, I just said, look, I can't beat you, so I'm gonna join you. Let's open up a restaurant.
At one time in history, every corner on the South Side of Chicago was occupied by a black entrepreneur. They came from that Mississippi mud, came from that Alabama soil, came from that Arkansas plantation.
This little light of mine, I'ma let it shine, I'ma let it shine.
My family is from Mississippi. They migrated to Chicago. And they brought all those traditions with them. When we were coming up with Crazy Hog, I knew that the sauce had to speak volumes. My grandmother made everything from scratch. She blessed us with that sauce. She blessed our business. She blessed her legacy. And boy, did it take off.
When you walk into Crazy.
Cade Martin Photography. Hashtag surprise me Cade. Winning gold, we have. The Martin Agency, Buffalo Wild Wings, Boneless Thugs in Harmony.
For 25 years, Bone Thugs in Harmony have continually reinvented rap. But today, a name change threatens to tear the group apart.
It's not an argument. We boneless, not check this out. Ain't no doubt about that.
A new love for boneless wings led to a new name.
We need to be boneless thugs now. Bottom line. I'm not gonna lie, but I like boneless wings, man. Whatever, it is what it is. Boneless wings, what?
But not everyone was on board.
I ain't changing shit.
The Martin Agency, Buffalo Wild Wings, Scoop, there it is.
Tasha, did you know Geico could save you hundreds on car insurance and a whole lot more? So what are you waiting for? Hip-hop group tag team to help you plan dessert?
Fresh vanilla, rocky road, chocolate, peanut butter, cookie dough.
Switch today and see all the ways you could save.
And winning Best in Show for the Advertising Show.
The Martin Agency. Geico. Bundling made easy.
We love our new home.
There's so much space.
We have a guest.
We have me heavy hands.
You're slouching again, Ted.
Expired.
Thanks, Aunt Bonnie.
It's a lot of house. I hope you can keep it clean.
At least Geico makes bundling our home and car insurance easy.
Which helps us save a lot of money.
Oh, Teddy, did you get my friend request?
I'll have to check.
Aunt Joni's here!
For bundling made easy, go to geico.com.
We love the new apartment.
The natural light is amazing.
Hardwood floors.
There is a bit of a clogging problem.
At least Geico makes it easy to bundle our renters and car insurance.
Yeah, helping us save even more.
For bundling made easy, go to geico.com.
The new house is amazing. So much character.
Original crown molding, walk-in closets.
We do have a rat problem. At least Geico makes bundling our home and car insurance easy.
It does help us save.
For bundling made easy, go to geico.com.
Congratulations to all the winners, and thank you for tuning in and staying safe. We'll see you again soon, Richmond. Please make sure to check out the full winners gallery on our website. This is Paul Schmidt. Thank you and good night.